right, it's finally working. All right, you guys, thank you for tuning in to Pouring Through Life. And today I am gonna do a wood oval. I'm gonna do a, this will be for a clock. This is a commission piece. So it's gonna be in the blues and greens with gold, and I'll go through those colors with you in just a second. I'm gonna do this bloom style because I suck at Dutch fours. I'm using black cell activator. My paint colors are going to be color art, color folk art, color shift black, color shift aqua. Then I have color shift emerald green, philanthroconome blue by artists or master's touch. Then I have deco art 24 karat gold. I also have deco art enchanted turquoise. It's this beautiful kind of like a color shift. Then I have folk art dragonfly glaze. It's the red, violet, blue. And lastly, deco art pearl. And this is a true blue pearl. So it's just a really luscious, pretty blue paint. My pillow paint is a combination of my pouring medium and a, why can't I think of the names today? I'm drawing up blank. It's a house paint by, Benjamin Moore. Sorry, I had to think about that. It's a semigloss white. So I mix them in here in a little manageable container. I also put GAC 800 to help reduce any cracking or anything like that. I just think it's easier to handle a small amount of paint in this. I guess I should put gloves on because house paint does not come off the same way that acrylic normal paints come off your skin. It really takes a bit more scrubbing than I would like to do. Providing I can find where I put my gloves. I don't know why my art space is such a mess today. I've been trying to organize and get things, in a more better position. Yeah, it's just been kind of a beating. I did some resining of my trivets. Here's one of them. Isn't it beautiful? Gosh. And so these colors are going to be similar to that. You really can see the iridescent stuff in this one. It's really quite spectacular, to be honest with you. Here's another one. And I like that I can get a consistent result so that you can have matching sets. It's always fun to me to get that. These ones are ready to be corked. Once I resin them, then I put cork on the back. Beautifuls, those little beauties. And then I did an 8x8 tile, a little bit bigger. Thanksgiving's coming. These would be beautiful on a Thanksgiving dinner table. If you are interested in purchasing anything that you see me make, just message me or email me. I will gladly get back to you. I respond very quickly to messages and what have you. So we're going to get down to this and hopefully it'll work out. We shall see, we shall see. I'm just going to pour my pillow paint here. You want a fair amount of paint on here because you want it to move as a unit. You don't want it to blow through and stick to the bottom. I don't pre-treat my wood rounds or anything like that because I don't really think it needs it. Some people find that they would like that done. I personally don't have an issue doing it that way. I'm gonna tilt this. My table's a little out of level. Okay, I'm gonna get right to it. First color is gonna be the black color shift. Nice and very thick paint. Okay, let me just get into it. If I don't get started, this paint's gonna all start rolling off. And then I'm gonna get mad. I like to put a contrast color in. I pretty much always start with black in my paintings. It really helps to give you some color depth. Put a lid on that. So that's the black. I love black and gold together. They complement each other very well. See, what did I tell ya? I knew it was gonna do it. Okay. Black and gold are my favorite colors together. And this color shift black is a cool color because it has a lot of gold colors to it. This is the phthalocyanine blue. Then I'm gonna do the turquoise color shift, which is that white, that one way it is white, the other way it is turquoise. I also like to drag the colors through to the other ones. Not really drag, or just drizzle them over. I'm gonna do emerald green now. This is the color shift emerald green by Folk Art. Then I'm gonna do the dragonfly glaze, the iridescent one that's violet, blue, and red. And it's very subtle. It's not something that changes any paint color or composition. It's a very subtle color. I'm gonna go ahead and throw some more gold in here. As I love gold, it always looks wonderful when you resin it. It's always my favorite color. Here's the aqua color shift. So much paint rolling off this right now. I'm gonna do a little tiny drizzle of the black. I'm gonna go to the pearl blue now. Try not to knock any of my little containers of paint over. I don't have a very large art space. I do my artwork in my dining room of my house. It helps me keep an eye on my kids. this is the dragonfly glaze again. I know it looks messy, but when I blow this out, you're gonna be shocked. I'm going to do the emerald green, the phthalocyanine blue, and then I'll be done. Come on. Actually, I lied. I'm going to do the aqua shift. This is the aqua. This is the turquoise. And so then I'm going to do the gold one more time. I know it's a lot of gold. It's worth it. Yeah, and the blue. I might actually just do a little dollop of blue and then that pearl blue one more time. Just because it looks so gorgeous when you put this light blue with the dark blue. And then for contrast, one more bit of white, because I'm gonna do black cell activator. And then I need to torch really quick. I just wanna clean my hands. My igniter went out on my torch, which sucks. Royally sucks. I'm so bummed. So I ordered a new torch, but it has not come in yet. And for those of you that paint a lot, know that torches are necessary. It's a must have in this world. Okay, I need to stop or I'm gonna keep putting more and more colors on and I'm never gonna get on to painting. Okay, so I'm gonna light my torch. Just to get rid of some bubbles. There's a lot of bubbles. All over here. And I see a hair. Okay, cool, honey. I don't know why my igniter went out. I probably got some paint on it because I do that constantly. Girls, I'm painting. Please be quiet. I'm shooting a video. Okay, so I'm gonna... Girls, last chance. Sophia, give it back to her. She's been playing with it. Quit leaning on Daddy's chair. Sophia, get off Daddy's chair like that. I'm gonna damage it. Okay, so I'm just gonna wipe this drip again, put it there so at least it's on the surface. I thought about pre-painting this a little bit, but I didn't do it. I should have, I guess. Honey, I'm working.
Hey fans, if you're watching this video, please like and subscribe.
That's my daughter Sophia. She is a YouTube genius. I think these kids are better at technology than us parents will ever be. Okay, so I'm gonna blow this with my blow dryer, which I've never done. I am gonna take off this insert so that it's more of a straight shot blow. I need you to be quiet. I'm trying to work here. Thank you. I've never done this before, so cross your fingers. Trying to keep all of my paint from rolling off. You don't need a whole heck of a lot of paint when you do these. What? And I always put too much paint. Always. It never fails. I'm just gonna blow. Okay, kids. If I have to repeat myself one more time, the iPads are going bye-bye. Do you understand? So I'm gonna blow because I want there to be more of the lacing in the center. It's gonna be awesome, you guys. I know I made y'all wait like forever, but I'm telling ya, oh, that's how I feel about this. When I see the lacing appear like magic, it makes me smile. I don't usually blow into the white, but might as well try it out. God, that's so friggin' pretty! Oh my Lanta, you guys. I actually see like a skull, like two eyeballs, a nose, and a mouth, and it'll go away when I stretch it. But isn't that funny? It kind of looks Halloween-y. Oh, I love it. Okay, I'm just torching again to get any more bubbles out. Oh my gosh, this is so pretty. L-O-V-E, that's what this is. Love it. I'm telling you, it just makes me so friggin' happy when you picture something in your head and it actually, yes, it's so amazing.
Have you ever had
happy dance, happy, happy, happy dance, happy, happy, happy dance. Mama's doing a happy dance. Mama's doing a happy dance and I'm losing my mind, but that's okay, okay, okay. Oh, I love it!
You're cray-cray.
I know. But what?
Is that a clock?
It will be eventually, yes. Daddy will put it on the back of this. Okay, I saw a hair, but I think I blew it away. Oh my gosh. Loving it, loving it. Just popping a bubble. Oh my goodness, it's freaking amazing. You want a lollipop? I'm still waiting for the center to kind of recollect itself.
But this thing is waffle.
You don't like that one.
Okay.
Oh my gosh! This is so freaking beautiful! I'm sorry, y'all, but I love the black cell activator. It's my favorite! Okay. Now I gotta move this paint around. Oh my gosh, it's so freaking pretty. Whoops. Okay, honey, what?
Have you ever had merch?
Merchandise?
Yeah.
Not for my site, no. Not yet, anyways. If I ever have some luck with my channel, then yes. But as of right now, the only merch I have is what I create. Look at how incredibly friggin' fraggin' gorgeous this is. Okay, so you really want it to move as one. And it has not released itself yet. So I am actually going to let this sit for a little bit longer. Oh my gosh, it's so freaking beautiful. I don't know why I didn't start blowing with my hair dryer sooner, because I freaking love this. And you guys, shh, I'm taping. I'm just gonna torch it again since I have to wait anyways. Oh my gosh. I am so jumping up and down for real, you guys. It's the most beautiful freaking thing I've ever seen in my entire life. Oh, my Lanta. My husband says it drives him nuts when I say my Lanta. It's so beautiful. I could cry. It's so beautiful.
Mommy.
Yes, honey.
Okay.
Hey, you guys, sit down on Daddy's chair, right? Or don't sit on it at all, please. And do not get sticky stickies all over the chair. Oh my gosh. I am so happy right now. This is like the third time I've poured over this specific piece of wood because it was not working. And I went out and I bought new house paint, the Benjamin Moore, and when I post this video, I will put a link to the new paint, because I have done 8 or 10 tiles with the Benjamin Moore, and not a single one has had even the hint of crazing. And it, I actually got paint that was on the like clearance table, found it for $10 a gallon, which is just score of the century, because I buy the bear, good expensive bear paint from Home Depot, and it's like $16 for a quart. Well, every other painting has crazing, and it's so frustrating. So I went out and I bought some new paint because I was sick of it. And I was like, oh, well, you know what, if I don't like it, no harm, no foul, it was cheap. But here's one that I did this weekend, and I haven't resined it or anything yet. There is not a drop of crazing on this paint, on this tile. Perfect condition. And that just makes me so happy, because not only is it a good price paint, but it seems to be better quality than all of the other paints that I've purchased. So I'm super excited. Okay, let's see if the center's popped up now. I've been rambling on. It's still not quite up, but that's okay. Let's just get it moving. I am gonna take my time, and I'm gonna kinda just move it back and forth. See, I don't have to worry about these sides because they are already covered from when I blew with my hairdryer. And I just, my main thing is I don't want it to roll over each other. So I don't wanna ruin the lacing. And I don't want that white flower. I want it to be black. Okay, so that's enough of that. Look at how freaking gorgeous this is. I literally, you guys, I could just cry. I'm been working on this style for months, trying to iron out the details with it, trying to get it to look lay right, dry right, most importantly, because when you are selling your art, your name is represented in the work that you do, and the people that purchase your art, for me it's so important that when they get it, that it lasts and that they love it and they're happy with it and they share with others what you made for them. And you know, word of mouth is all you can do right now, and it's so incredibly important that they're happy with the work that you do and that you're happy. And unfortunately, there is something right there. And let me get it out before it ruins everything. Did I get it? Some sort of clumpy clump of whatever. Nope, I didn't get it. What the heck? I do not know what that was. Okay, well, let's just keep going. Because, you know, they're gonna share and display your artwork. So it's, to me, I mean, it's precious. It's absolutely precious to me when somebody I've made something for is like shares with their family and their friends or coworkers or whomever may be, that they're like, yeah, pouring through life makes incredible pieces of work. Shannon is awesome. Look at how creative and beautiful these are, and they hold up, and they, you know, that's what I want to hear. Okay, so now that I've got coverage, I'm going to stretch it back down. Oh, it's just so beautiful. I can't even tell you how happy I am. I am just in awe right now. I can't wait to send a picture of this to my husband. He's gonna lose his freaking mind. So I'm moving it slowly because I really don't like this white leaf from when I overblew. So I want to get rid of it, or at least most of it. But if I see, it's not terrible, but if I see that I'm losing any of my composition by trying to remove that little petal, then I will stop because I don't want to ruin what I'm working on. I just can't believe it. It's so freaking beautiful. Okay, so I'm done tilting. I'm gonna put, just wanna work on the composition a little bit. Whoa. It's getting slippery. She's watching TV, honey. And you're supposed to be doing schoolwork.
I'm on recess.
Yeah, but that's probably over by now because you've been out here at least 15 minutes. Okay? See all the gold? That's why I put it in, because it's always adds an additional depth of color that is remarkable. And out of these paints, there's only one paint that is not a metallic or a color shift, and that's the Philanthroquinone Blue. And I will put a in the description box of the video, I am going to put the names of all the paints I used, and the pillow paint and my pouring medium and all that. I'll put that in the description box or the video link on how I make my pouring medium. Maybe I'll do that. The video, I have a video. I should number them like everybody else does. But I haven't done that because I haven't been doing this for very long. I'm just scraping the drips because I don't want the drips to keep pulling the paint off of the face of this clock. Well, this will be a clock eventually. If you don't collect your drips, your painting will get ruined. Oh my gosh, it's so beautiful. I'm telling you, I'm not joking when I said I could just cry. I'm beyond happy. Okay, so let me get these nasty gloves off and I will take you in for a close-up. That's my four-year-old singing, by the way. Isn't she talented? Go Ava, you are such a good singer. I can't believe how beautiful this is. Oh. Okay. Let's get in here. The detail is remarkable. Look at the multicolored cells. That's why I drizzle the paint the way that I do. You do the puddles, yes, and then you drizzle because it creates a depth of color that you would not get if it was just straight puddles. That area right there. That actually looks like a flower. I can't get over how incredibly beautiful this piece is. If you're interested in purchasing this piece, I will put my email address. It will not be available for a couple of weeks because it's got to dry, cure, and then be resined. But wow. Just wow. All right, you guys, if you like my videos, please hit the subscribe button and the notification bell. That way, when I post additional videos, you will get notified of them. Thank you guys for your support. It means the absolute world to me and my family. And thank you again. So have a blessed day and we'll see you on the next video.